like they have some medical emergency here. So we have our R93 R94 came. I lost them because he came without sirens. Anyway, after engine 94, EMS 94 showed up, and now looks like they're gonna transport. Looks like they're gonna transport someone. Anyway, so as you can see again, EMS 94-4, well-paid firefighter, average paycheck is $277,000 plus the vehicle and expenses. So here we go. After you have R94, that's two more, that's six person paid average $277,000, usually, like, you know, what's his name, Samuel Cha. He doesn't like when I mention his name because he's a public employee and he makes $315,000 or $318,000 according to the public information on the, what's the name of it, Transparent California. So two firemen inside, four left, so that's average four times $277,000. And this is the newly operating ambulance. City of Torrance had this long time. City of Torrance had an ambulance for a very long time. They never used it. They started to use it from April the 1st when City of Torrance started to do the transporting. They decided instead of McCormick, that cost the city nothing. It's not good enough, so Torrance is gonna do the transport. As you can see, they already had two vehicles. They already had two vehicles, and now they have three. Manhattan Beach give them a loaner. Anyway, these two employees, the driver makes like, I think, like $15 an hour. And the other guy makes like almost $20, and they are the cheapies. But the city of Torrance going to buy seven more brand new ambulances. What they have a problem manufacturing. Of course, they buy all those on credit. They're gonna buy the ambulances on credit. Somebody buys it and they pay it back. So somebody donating them money, and this gonna be some kind of a lease option to buy. Anyway, so looks like they have difficulty to get the patient out here. I don't know. This is another funny thing. So they can take the gurney in there with them. Look at this setup. So here is an apartment building. They cannot take the gurney in. So looks like they got a wheelchair kind of thing. They're gonna put the patient in the wheelchair and haul it here and transport it or transfer the patient from the wheelchair here. Anyway, but the point of my video is not that. My point of the video is four firefighters with the engine showed up. That's over $1 million, $277,000 average pay. You know, the captain and the engineer makes more than $300,000 or close to $300,000. Anyhow, so then you have R94, and now they try to bring the patient out of the room or whatever. So that's two more. Six very well paid firefighters. It's like 1.2 million, 1.5 million for the city, and plus the ambulance. So 1.5 million to the city show up here, have difficulty to move the patient. And you know, these technicians, they decide if you should go. These are like EMS responders, you know, medical, emergency medical service, but you know, they are like paramedics, you know. They know some procedures, but they way far from a doctor. So instead of hiring doctors to come to a scene like this, and the doctor could decide if you need an ambulance or not, we have eight people show up, over a million and a half dollars expenses, and none of them is a doctor. And as you can see, it's supposed to be an emergency. Now I am here like almost 10 minutes. So just think about these people. You need medical emergency, you are in a medical emergency, and instead of a doctor coming to your house, they set up the system, you call 911, then they call the fire department, and the fire department shows up. Sometimes they are at the beach, you can watch my videos, and you know, these guys going to the beach all the time. So that's only a mile and a half extra to drive from the fire station, but that's okay. That's, they come with the sirens and everything. That's like only a minute and a half, 2 minutes extra, but they are not in a hurry, because as you can see, I'm here like 10 minutes and nobody is coming. So, and if you are really in an emergency and they would go very fast, you are like 20, 30 minutes from a doctor. You know, a doctor could come here, but screw that. Some doctors don't make $300,000 a year. Average doctor doesn't make $300,000 a year, but the average firefighter in Torrance make $277,000 a year, average. Some of them a little less, some of them a little more. Fire chief makes almost $500,000, but you know, he's a hard worker. He puts up these charts, how much money they make. And the other interesting thing, people bought this ambulance. People pay for the workers, you know, the driver and the technician. And when the ambulance come, what the people paid for charges the same amount of money for services what McCormick would charge, the maximum allowed amount of money by the state of California. And guess what? People pay for this ambulance, people pay for the staff, and McCormick was free. People did not have to pay McCormick, people did not have to pay McCormick's, employees. people had to pay the same amount for a transportation or for a transport for McCormick as they pay for the Torrance fire transport. Now, imagine people, this is the same like you buy the grocery store, you pay the grocery clerks, and when you wanna buy groceries, you pay for the groceries. Only in Torrance. And now they already, the last city council meeting, they said they already in the black. They already making profits. Already making profits with three ambulances. One of them is a loaner. Anyhow, I shut this down. This is just an example for all this money. For all this money, what you get for all this money? Look at that. They successfully measured the vital signs. Everything is cool, I think. And they put all your information in that little computer. And this must have been some extra because they, I don't know what is in that huge bag. I'm gonna have to find out. I don't know. So that's something in that huge bag. Because the orange suitcase, that was the defibrillator. The blue is for the vital signs like blood pressure and heartbeat and oxygen level. And now they put on the gloves. Man, he puts on the gloves after he was in contact with the patients. Anyway, the nice thing is they're wearing face masks, but as you know, it's up to their discretion if they get a shot or not, because lots of people doesn't want to take the immunization. So anyhow, so this is a funny part. See, they had a wheelchair for climbing the stairs, and then they had to transfer the patient from the wheelchair. They had to transfer the patient from the wheelchair to the gurney. So anyway, I hope the guy gonna be okay. And look at that, I'm here. Can't see on my screen, but over 10 minutes. All right, I'm just recording like 15 minutes, and the guy is still, I'm not filming the guy, but the guy is still on the gurney. Look at that, this guy cannot put an equipment back. Look at that. These are the newly trained, what you would call an EMS employees. He had difficulty to put the equipment back in its place. It's a quite a big spot. Anyway, so I'm here like 15 minutes, and as you can see, the guy is still in the ambulance. Not a doctor here yet. 15 minutes, and not a doctor. Not a doctor see the patient in 15 minutes. Millions of dollars spent, and in 15 minutes, the guy did not see the patient yet. It's gonna be a 3-4 minute ride to the hospital. It's going to be, admitting to the emergency room. So they're gonna go probably with the sirens because the guy was in pretty bad shape. I don't wanna see. I'm not making the videos to film the patients. Anyway, so now we are here, 15 minutes in the call. Probably they called them 20 minutes ago, and the guy is still here. The guy did not see a doctor yet. They have to get to a hospital. The closest one is about almost 2 miles from here, and if he has insurance with the other company, that's like 5 miles. and hopefully the guy survives, because as you can see, about 20 minutes the guy did not see a doctor yet, and look at the speed they go with. Anyhow, Andy Porchup signing off. See you on the next one. Bye-bye.